Hello and welcome to my channel. This video today is going to be on the MySQL Workbench, and we're going to be using the Schema Transfer Wizard to take one schema, and in this case it's going to be the National Provider Database, and load it onto another server, another MySQL server. And so the tool is located in the database tool right here. You see Schema Transfer Wizard. So let's get started and do that. So I'm going to maximize my window, and then I'm going to close this tab, and we'll go to the home view so you can see the two connections I'm using. So the first connection is my local instance, so I open that. You don't have to open these, but I'm just going to do that to show you for context. So you can do that without these connections open at all. So you see that I have in my local instance, I'm going to filter on the NPS data just so we can focus on that and not be distracted. So now when I run a query on that, you'll see that it's returned my record sets. And that's just the first 1,000. And then on the second one, I'll do the same thing. You'll see that we don't have any tables in the NPI database here. Let me just run a record. Yeah, it doesn't even give the option to do the first 1,000. That makes sense because you don't have any. What table? So now let's go to the, let's start the wizard. So I'll, let's go to the home screen. I don't think you need to, but so it's the Schema Transfer Wizard under the database menu, and you'll see it just opens up this large dialogue. I wish it was kind of standalone, but I can't get it to do that. So I'm just going to do start the wizard, and simply asks you what's your source and what's your destination. So I have so you have to have the connections already defined. I'm going to click the local instance, and I'm going to click my web server, and then you can test the connections to know that they're working. So I'm going to click test connections right down here, and you'll see up here it says both of those connections have succeeded. So now I'm going to click next, and it asks what schema you want to transfer. So even though we filtered it, it includes all of them. So I'm just going to click the NPI provider database here. That's a medical provider database, isn't it? And I'm going to click start copy. And it says it already exists, even though we don't have any tables in it. That's okay. I'm going to click yes. So it's going to overwrite the whole database. So keep that in mind. And let's look at the logs while it's doing this. So you see that it does it through it says it's reverse engineering, but basically it creates SQL statements from, you know, everything in your schema, and then executes those SQL statements. And then when it's done that, it gives you a summary, and then starts copying the data over. So in my case, it takes about 5 to 10 minutes to copy this over, and then it's done. And you'll see it's making good progress here. It's quite a bit less than 5 to 10 minutes, probably just 3 or 4. So I'm just going to pause while that's finishing, and then I'll come back. Okay, so that didn't take long at all, and you'll see the log has shown us, you know, how successful we were. So you see the copy helper is finished. I guess that's another name for it, and it tells you how many rows were copied. So it's 480,000 blah 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 out of 480,000 blah blah blah, and you know, so we're good. One table, one out of one. So you get all your results here, and probably if there's error, it's going to show you how many error rows were created. So we're good to go. We can just hit next and finish, and we're done. So that's it. That's how you are. Actually, let's go to let's do a select on that now, or let's refresh this database. So I'm in my web server again. We'll do a refresh on the database, and so now we should see there should be tables here. Try that again. There we go, and we have the other names table. So we'll do a select the first 1,000 rows, and we're good to go. Let's do a select count to see if we actually in fact have 480,000 some odd records. So I'll execute that. And yeah, we have the exact correct number. So I hope you enjoyed this little video, and hope this tool helps you move your data around as necessary. And if you like these videos, make sure you subscribe and click on the alarm bell so you're notified of future videos. Thanks, and have a great day.